Hey guys, what's up? Today we're here to talk about DC's Electric Warriors, issue 1. Let's get into it. So this story picks up on Earth, 2735 AD. If any of you might know what AD stands for, let me know down in the comments. Anyway, there's a fight in a bar where this kid is picking a fight against a lion. Mind you, this is a future where the animals have evolved and at some point took over humans, that humans had to sign some kind of accord to make them sort of equal again. But this kid basically says that humans were always supposed to be in charge, which I don't really agree with him. But anyway, he picks up this fight with a lion, and as you can imagine, he's getting his butt kicked. At some point, he plays dirty and is about to end it with a bottle. Just get beat up by other lions. Mind you, he started this fight, and he's the one that needed to get it bruised. After that, we sort of pick up with this octopus girl lady. She's sort of like an Atlantean, well, mostly because she's underwater. Well, we find out that this might actually be the main DC timeline, because like Superman, Batman, Wonder Woman, the Trinity, the Justice League, they're like legends here, and they're proved they were here, but this would be somewhere far into the future where like the heroes are done, basically. So the kid picks himself up after the fight, somehow makes it onto the street with people just staring at him. It looks like it might be somewhat popular, because this might not be the first time it happened. Everyone just looking at him with a sense of, oh, it happened again. So he goes up to this woman selling fast food, like Jokerized fish. So I can only go ahead and guess how this happened. Like someone released the Joker venom into the ocean or something. And he actually comments that if you eat this fish, you most likely die or something, but now it just makes you numb. So after that, he just walks up to this doctor nurse in a van. She stitches him up and gives him a ride home, but we find that this guy has been living credits. He's been eating on credit, getting his wounds checked on credit, so it's somewhat lucky just to live around like that. Anyway, we pick up to him at home, and we find out the entire reason he started this whole fight. Basically, his father left them for some sort of freedom rights movement or something, and he's being taken care of by his mother, he and his brother. His younger brother has been chosen to wield their seal, I think, and He doesn't agree with it. He says it's basically a death sentence, like while his mother says it's an honor. But then we cut into this scene where it's like a Hunger Games gladiator type match, and this guy just got his arms ripped off, okay? And in retaliation to what the alien did to him, this alien's already hurt, might I add, he slices him in half with his wings. Now that's just brutal. That's the Hunger Games on a whole new level. But anyway, this doesn't have to be the main reason he keeps getting angry and keeps picking fights, because I believe he thinks that he should have been the one out there going to fight instead of his brother. Because as you can see, you get your arms ripped off and you don't have regenerative healing factor like someone like Doomsday or the Shaggy Man. Good luck. But seeing as this is the future, probably have some kind of regeneration chamber or something. Anyway, it turns out that they're heading towards another match, and the octopus lady is representing the Atlanteans or underwater tribe, and like she's being welcomed by fellow animal sapiens or something. Someone tell me the correct term for that, because I have no idea. Anyway, as they're being cheered on in front of like this skyscraper, they undergo a process called electrogenesis, basically like giving them powers to prepare them for the fight coming in. My god, that dude just looks epic. I mean, for you to wear a giant W on your face, you definitely need to be epic. They all sort of got this code name to them. The octopus chick is called Deep Dweller, and he's called Warcry, explaining the giant W on his face. Although there's a little tease about like Darkseid or some kind of apocalyptic influence design, because his headpiece it has a chin gear thing that's very similar to what Darkseid wears. But hey, it might not be, just let me know. Anyway, he's also given Superman's cape by these humans, saying it's a representation of what they once were. And Superman was an alien, might I add, but it was more human than most people. And basically, this cuts to a point when he's talking to her and he's remembering something. And this is where we find out it's not his brother, Oscar, that is being taken to this planet to fight. It's actually the older one that picked the fight. He sort of tricked his brother into going to his alleyway with him and then ambushed him. I think he has some good intentions, but that's just a dick move to attack your brother that way, even though you're doing it for his own good. It's just a dick move. Anyway, we cut to this battle arena coliseum called the Covenant in Sector 666. Now, if you're a Green Lantern fan, you know precisely where this sector is. you know exactly where this sector is. But I'm not entirely sure if like in this timeline the Red Lanterns are still around, but I guess we'll just have to keep reading to find out. And basically, this story is giving us the sense that all the heroes, like way back when, they're all gone, they're all dead. But we cut to a page and we find out the very end that Firestorm is alive somehow. Okay, maybe this might not be the Firestorm from main continuity or the main DC timeline, but like the Firestorm Matrix chose someone, and like this guy remembers who Firestorm was. And it basically looks like he's being set out to be the main bad guy for the story, but who knows, it might just turn to something else entirely. So that's it. The issue overall was pretty good, and it was more like a prelude, like just letting you know what it is to come. And I'm really looking forward to it. Kind of hope that the issue just runs quickly and like we get to see issue 2 really quick. Come on, DC, get moving. And that's it for this video. You can like, share, comment down below if there are any topics that I'd like me to do a video on. Subscribe if you're new to this channel. Follow me on Instagram and on Twitter. And I'll catch you all later.